around and walk into another installment of all this GMS on location. We're down here at the main camp, which is located on 34, West 34th and 7th Avenue, across the street from the famous Macy's, we're here to just do what we do. Basically, today's show is going to be entitled "Thy Shame Shall Be." Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, thy shame shall be seen. Now let's get the scripture on that. Isaiah 47:3. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen. Psalm 105. Isaiah 47:1. Come down and sit in the dust, O worthy daughter of Babylon. Alright, and that's talking about you so called white people, you Edomites. What the Most High is saying in the scripture through Isaiah. By the mouth of Isaiah is that somebody in the dust represents confusion. So now you're confused because you see Israelites popping up all over the place. Basically you don't know what's really going on. Now we read the scriptures and we break the scriptures down to everybody so you know what's going on, but then you don't know what's going on. So you're basically in a confused state. And that includes your elite, starting with the Rothschild elite, going back to the Rockefellers. You're aware of us. You see us on YouTube. You have people come up to you and speak about the Hebrew Israelites. Now we're all over the place. All over the world, literally, man. And it looks like the prophecies being fulfilled. Because the Most High is going to raise us up as a standing army, man. He's going to raise us up as an army. But not a physical army, but a spiritual army. And all the weapons is his weapons, man. Give me that, hold on, give me that in Corinthians, I believe it's 2 Corinthians 10, 3 and 4. See, we see what we're shooting down. We're shooting down your lives. That's all we're doing. We're shooting down your lives. For 2 Corinthians 2:4, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. Yeah, because nothing else is trying to catch these Arabs talking about their terrorists. We thought we'd run down that made a bomb, he will blow up this building, he will blow up that building. But you can't put that on us because the only bombs that we're doing is the bombs of truth. They're the only thing we're doing. And this is hurting you too. So there's a lot of people out there watching us. But it says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through the Most High to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, right? Casting down imaginations. All right? But if somebody go around and take a picture of Caesar, those guys, crashing down the imagination. Because you so-called white people, you came over here to this country, to the New World, and we're going to get into Christopher Columbus, we're going to get into your Abraham speaking Lincoln's Emancipation Proclamation. When you look the word emancipation, at the word emancipation from the Latin word, which means to transport. So we will never made free. That's what your imagination goes through. It's about, that's why you put Rome blind. That's why you put 666 on his forehead. That's why you put a serpent stone coming out of his mouth. Because that's who this guy is. This is the devil. That's who he is. So any weapons that we're using the weapons of truth. All right? For the weapons of our war are for casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of the Most High, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Yahweh. Yeah, because there's a lot of you Edomites who watch our videos, and some of you Edomites even made videos and come out and admit that the real Jews would have to be the blacks in America. It's overwhelming. There's a reason why you don't put us, you don't have a new, you know, anything that goes on, there's always a new truck. Remember the Channel 7 news truck? They don't even come, you haven't seen a news truck in years come back that deal. And I said, basically, when you watch that movie shows you who the devil is. And the devil is a white man. And his money. And his people. And his daddy. My man, here I saw him, went out and saw the movie, The Butler. Lee Daniels, The Butler. And that movie shows that the white man is the devil. They try to portray a lot of puzzles in there, but they had two sides. They were really nice around the puzzle. That's bullshit, man. That's bullshit. But like I said, that movie, The Butler, shows you that the white man, the devil, but they show two accounts that took place because that movie is based upon a true story. This is 2 Nephi chapter 5, 6, verse 28. As your faith, it shall flourish, corruption shall be overcome, and the truth, which has been so long without truth, shall be declared. The truth is being declared now. It is not coming out of the mouth of the white man. Like you got this guy, who's the guy, Bradley Manning? He's just got convicted, right? As soon as his government changes his hands, the 25 years, guess what? He went to damn sex training change operation. He didn't change his name to Chelsea. Then you got this guy, Ed Snowden. Now, if I do that in someone's name, Ed Snowden, he, Bradley or Chelsea, Manny, Ed Snowden, and others, bringing out all the debt on the damn devils. You bring it out the debt on yourself by being a damn man. All you white people are damn faggots in one way or another. You can't help it. Psalms chapter 10, verse 1. Why standest thou far off, O Lord? Why hidest thou thyself in times of trouble? The wicked in his pride is ready to perform. Let them be taken in the devices that they have imagined. For the wicked boasted of his heart's desire, and blessed the covetous from the Lord above. The wicked, through the pride of his countenance, will not seek after the Most High. The Most High is not in all his thoughts. His ways are always grievous, thy judgments are far above out of his sight. As for all his enemies, he puffeth at them. He hath said in his heart, I shall not be moved. For I shall never be an adversary. His mouth is full of cursing and deceit and fraud. Under his tongue is mischief and vanity. He sitteth in the lurking places of the villages, in the secret places that he murdered the villager. His eyes are privily set against the poor. He lies in wait secretly as a lion in his den. He lies in wait to catch the poor. He does catch the poor when he draws him into his net. He crouches and humbles himself, that the poor may fall by his strong ones. He hath said in his heart, the Most High has forgotten. He hideth his face, he will never see it. Arise, O Lord, O power, lift up thy hand, forget not the humble. Therefore, if the wicked contend the Most High, he hath said in his heart, thou wilt not require it. Thou hast seen it, for thou beholdest mischief and strife, to require it with thy hand. The poor, amazing himself unto thee. Remember the poor and referring to Israelites. Now, we don't give a damn about no poor prophet. Or I don't give a damn about no destitute Edomite. Or no damn Moabite. And basically, we don't give a damn about Israel either. We the only ones we can talk about are the Israelites that are up here left, man. But you keep asking, you I'm not going to make it. So why can't I give a damn about you? Like me, who said in that video with the so-called GMS number was wrong, he said, that guy is the black women and you black men, that's what he said. And then he put the black women before the black men. So now he thought about the women, then. He was like, I was wrong.